In this video, we'll try to understand how we can read, insert, update and delete data using Entity Framework. As we have said in the previous two videos, there are two classes, Context and Entities. The Context class is the main central mediator. It acts like a bridge or a connector between all the participants. So it fires SQL to the DB, loads the entities and gives the output back, you know, to the UI or, you know, to the caller. So when you say you want to do insert, update, delete or read operation, the first thing what should come to your mind is creating the object of the context class. So our context class in this scenario is customer entities. So basically, you know, I've just gone to the designer.cs file. You know, in other words, as I've said in the previous part of the video, we have EDMX and then we have EDMX behind code, right? So I've gone to the EDMX behind code. And in that, you know, we have two regions, if you remember, context and entities. So if you click on this plus sign here, you will get the context name. So the first thing is we need to go and create the object of this context because he is the mediator, he is the connector. So we'll say here customer entities, obj context is equal to new customer entities. So let's first start with reading data. Okay. So we'll first start with reading data. After that, we'll look into inserting data. We will then look into updating data. And finally, we'll look into deleting data. Okay, simple, simple examples. So now let's say I want to go and read, you know, all the country data into a list. So this is the country data we have here, country name and population. So we'll say that, okay, we want to go and get all the countries into this obj countries object. So as I've said that this obj context is the bridge, so we have to say here obj context dot please get me countries. You can see now how the naming convention is coming here, countries. Remember that checkbox, you know, when we said please select plural. So you can see for one record he's saying country, that means for one object he's saying country, and for a lot of country records he's saying countries. Okay, so you can see now the effect of that checkbox, you know, when we checked it as plural. Okay, so here I'm saying, okay, go and fetch me everything what is there in the table now into this obj countries collection. Okay, and finally we'll go and display this. So we'll say here for each, you know, start reading every country record which is flourished inside this countries collection. Okay, so we'll display both the country name as well as the population. So I'll say here please display the country name and also the corresponding population. Now you can see how the property name is matching with the field names, you know, so everything is ready made over here as compared to, you know, manually when we go and create our classes, you know, we have got all this thing ready made here. The context class is created, the country class is created, right? So now if I do a control F5, we should be able to see all the list of countries. So let me, so there it is. Now you can see that whatever records are there in the database, that is India, Nepal and USA, all those records are now displayed using Entity Framework into your console application. So that was a very simple example of reading data. Now the next thing is we would like to go and insert some data, right? So we would like to go and insert some country and population correspondingly. So in order to insert a new country data, we have to first create a fresh country object. So we'll say, okay, obj country, country, obj country equal to new country. Okay. And they will give your country name. So I'll say, okay, country name is Sri Lanka. So, and country population something. Okay. Right. Okay. So you can see that I have created a new country object here. And this country object, we would like to go and insert it into database, you know, by using Entity Framework. Now this data over here, like, you know, Sri and, you know, the population can come from console application. It can come from a WinForm text box. It can come from a ASP.NET user control. So, you know, that is irrespective. Okay. So currently I've just hard coded the data to make this example simpler. So again, you know, if you want to insert this country object into the database, you have to go via the context. Why? Because the context is a bridge, he's a connector. Okay. So we have already created the context object over here, obj context. So we'll use the same object. So we'll say obj context dot countries. Please add this object to the database. Obj country. Right. And build it. Nice. So let us put a debug point here. Let's do F5. So there our code is running. The add object method is called. Now let's quickly jump back to the database and let's see if Sri Lanka is added in the database, and it is not. Surprising, right? Well, basically this add object method actually adds records in memory. So in other words, for example, let's say that you want to, you know, insert hundreds of country records to SQL Server. So before that, what you'd like to do is, you know, you'd like to first add everything in memory. You'd like to validate it, right? So everything happens in your RAM here. And once, you know, all the things are validated, then you would like to say, okay, now save the changes. Okay. So this add object method actually just adds in memory. Okay. Now, in order to commit this record to the database, you have to say here obj context dot save changes. So this is just an in-memory commit, okay, and this one is actually a physical commit. In other words, here, you know, it will actually create a SQL statement, fire an insert command to the SQL server, and will try to save the Sri Lanka record into the database. Okay, so let's see if this works or not. So I'm going to go and put a F5, a debug point here, and I will do a F5. So there we go. Add object is done. Now save changes. And let's go to our database, execute, and you can see that Sri Lanka record has been inserted, and that is the population. So that was a very simple example of an insert. So if you want to insert a record, first thing, create the object, set all the properties, call add object, and then say save changes. So now let's see a simple example of update. So for updating, the first thing what we need to do is we need to go and select a country object, right? So I'm going to say a country. So we need to select which object we want to update. So what I'll do is I'll take the first country object which comes in this country's collection. So I'll say here obj countries. So whatever is the first record, I would like to go and update this record. So the first step is we need to go and select the record. Second step, we need to go and do the updation. So I'll say here obj update dot population is equal to, let's say, 900. And finally, you know, when you have done with the changes, you have to say here obj context dot save changes. Great. Also, let me go and comment this insert here. Why? Because this country code, this country name actually has a unique key. So there is a possibility that if I run this code again, you know, it will crash. So what I've done is I've just gone ahead and I've commented this code. So let me put a debug point here. Let me do F5. So there it goes. So the first country what is selected here is India IND. The population is 1000 and we are trying to change that population to 900. So if you see in the database here, if I do execute, you can see that the population is 1000. Great. So I'm changing it to 900 and I'll say save changes. Now let me go back to my database here and let me do execute, and you can see that India population has been added, it has been updated from 1000 to 900. Great. Now, if you wish to go and delete an object, again, the process is almost same. So first thing, you select the record, which we have already done. After that, we will say obj context dot countries dot delete object, this obj update. Okay. So obj update, right. And then again, save changes. Remember, you have to call save changes, you know, after insert, after update, after delete. So save changes actually, you know, commits, you know, this whole changes to the database. And then I'll say save changes, right? So let's see now if this works. So we are trying to delete the India record. Okay. So let me do F5. So there it goes. Delete object, save changes. Now let's go to SQL Server. Let's do execute. And you can see that India record is no more available in the table. So I hope that you enjoyed this video. In this video, we were trying to, you know, show you how to do insert, update, and delete using Entity Framework. Thank you so much.